You've come to have your portrait sketch today, am I right? Well, you've picked a very windy day for it. But don't worry, I will put away the wind chimes so we can have some peace and quiet. But before we start, can we just take a quick look through my tools and equipment and show you kind of what I'm going to be doing today? What type of drawing? Any input from you would also be greatly received. Let's take a look at my pencils and just see what we've got on offer today. You see all my colours nicely sharpened and ready. I love the look of it. A lot of coloured pencils all sharp and pointed. Let's test them on this paper here and do some shades, starting with the sketch set. There's lots of different shades. Obviously, they will get increasingly more deep in tone, so we just want to make a judgment as to which one's the best to use. So starting off with this 2H, we're expecting a very, very, very fine line here. So I'll just start by softly pressing the pencil in and slowly but surely increasing the pressure. This one's a little bit harder to use, I'm not enjoying it as much. And I just thought then I'd better label what each one is, so I don't forget. 2H is already standing out to me as the better option of these. Next we're going to try a B. And just lightly press down. Lovely. I do like that variation. That is solid second place. And next, what do we have? A HB. Now, this is just a classic pencil that you're given in school. I remember everybody getting a HB pencil. So I'm not expecting big things. Yeah, there's not much tone in that. Not something I would want for too much definition. Maybe I've got for lining. And we've got a quite deep. comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'll be beginning the portrait now. I'm using some of the colours we've discussed, pretty much all of the pencils, but I'll tell you what I'm doing as I'm doing it. But first of all, do you need anything? A beverage? Anything? No? Okay. No problem. I'm gonna get started then with my pencils and just sketch. Just sketch, sketch, sketch. An outline of your face. Okay. I'm gonna start using the B pencil. I feel it's the sharpest and it looks fine, but not too fine. I'm quite happy with it. So let me just come in and have a feel around the face just to see what shape I'm working with. Okay. So it's kind of heart-shaped. Got a little dimple right there, and I'm just going to capture that straight away before I get carried away with the features. I think these things are really important. And you've got a little scar next to your eye there. What did you do? That's interesting. I've got scars from chickenpox next to my eyes, and I've got a cut on my finger here from stabbing myself accidentally with a broken glass. And I was about 15. Okay. The hairline kind of goes into a bit of a square there. Yeah. I'm capturing all of that, don't worry. It's quite nice, isn't it? Just having an informal session and chat. I personally enjoy it. Quite a lot of these sessions. Usually I get like a family portrait request, or you know, a couple's portrait, something like that. I'm just starting to smooth down the face, capturing the lines of the nose. I'm just starting to smooth my pencil down the lines of your nose so that I get the width correct for your nose. Like that. Perfect. And have you got any freckles or moles? Three moles just there. I've got lots of moles as well. Do you like your moles? Yeah. Well, that's good. So a lot of people don't like them, but I think they're beauty marks. Just capturing the arch of the eyebrow. Like this. Fill them in soon. I'm more just doing a lining at the moment, so I'll probably use something darker to sort of imitate the bushiness. This is just purely a lining. I just want to mark the face. Just the eye shape. Nice almonds. Beautiful. We're going to have a lot of fun capturing that colour as well with the eyes. It's quite rare, as I'm sure you know. Just get in the middle of the face here and just start shaping out the Cupid's bow. Just so I can get the shape of the lip. Nice sharp corners. Beautiful. I finished everything I want to with first lining. Just make sure I've got your cheekbones kind of planned out. You do need a deeper shade, but that's fine. I'll get to that, no problem. Let's now pick the next pencil. So if you recall, the 3B gave us a really nice deep shade. So let's do that for the eyebrows now. And I'm just going to imitate the bushiness of hair like this. Like this. Just gentle flicks with my pencil. Luckily they are quite even as well. Mine definitely not. distant cousins, not sisters, not twins. Okay. Just get that arch delicately. Add it to the edges of the lips like that. It will just show that you have a really defined lip shape. And it will just add effect to the lines, the wrinkles that we drew. Contrasts really well with the cheek blush colour. This is a lot deeper, a lot bolder, and it just highlights that talking is where you get most of your expression from, your personality, through your words. And it's a beautiful feature, it's nice to highlight it to people. So three colours, I'm quite happy with that. I'm going to go back to my pencils and just, just add a little bit more definition in places where I just want to make sure everyone knows it's you, anything that makes you unique. A bit of shading under the chin. I've picked this 2H, which is a very light scratchy pencil. I don't want to go in too heavy. I'm going to use this to now define the dimple in your chin. Just show a bit of depth to it. You just make sure I'm placing it right. That's perfect. Any more details? Under eye bags, start there. So I've made you look a little bit less tired than you look. But honestly, everybody has marks under their eyes. I think it just shows life, you know? So just let me know. It's just super light, don't worry. It sounds heavier than it is. Use my fingers to just smudge out the detail, and it looks perfect. Just a couple of lines. I think that's everything. Let me take a closer look. I think that's every detail that I want. I'm quite happy with it. You want to see? I'm afraid it's not quite ready to be viewed yet. I still need to smudge it a little bit and, you know, maybe add some depth. But as for you, sitting there and watching, your work is complete. You were an amazing model today. Thank you so much. This is going to be one to remember. I think you'll be proud to show this portrait off in your house. And thank you so much for taking part. I really, really, really am grateful.